Welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to be showing all of you how to use a Creality 3D scanner to scan something intricate and detailed, just like this amazing Hot Wheels monster truck. It's not mine, it is my son's, or is it? So I've chosen this exact item because it's really small, it's really intricate, it's going to be a challenge, but I want you guys to be able to see the full workflow that I go through with my Creality scanners to make sure I go from physical to 3D, show you exactly what you need. So stay tuned and we'll get straight to it. We'll be using Creality Scan software and this is version 4. So the first thing I always like to do is just create a specific title for what I'm doing so you can always find it. So the first thing we want to do is set up the scan here. So we're going to use something called a global marker. And this is where we use reflective markers, and you often get them with the Creality scanners, to actually map out our scanning platform before we actually do it. And what this will actually do is it will allow it the process to be much simpler when you do actually get round to doing it, because it already knows where everything is, so it can reference points and get exactly where it needs to go. Now we're gonna get our first proper scan ready, and this will be the top side. I'm gonna do a bottom side and a top side. We'll be using point cloud, 0.2 resolution, and color mapping. So sit back, enjoy it, and I'll get back to you guys once these scans are done and I'll explain the next step. I hope you guys enjoyed that. So we are now going on to the fusion aspect. We've done two scans and we've used point clouds. So there's lots of different points. We now need to fuse them together, and we can specify different things, ultra detail, different resolution, standard. You can remove the markers, which we want, and it's going to process it and get us in a point right now. As you can see, we've got two jumbled up scans, but we can now clean up those scans, and I'm going to talk you through that process. This is probably the most daunting thing for most people, but it's actually really, really intuitive and actually quite simple. So what you want to do, what I like to do first, okay, is I like to look at top down view of my car or my item. As you can see here, hold shift on your keyboard and with the left mouse button, just drag a fence around that item. There you go. And now we're going to invert it. So everything outside of that selection is gone. Select delete. You've already cleared up 90% of things here. We're going to do the same side on here. And you have to be quite intricate because you don't want to delete the good parts. But as you can see right there, we've got our first scan cleaned up, ready to go. So we're going to click on scan number 3 now. And we're going to do exactly the same for this one. This is the bottom of our car. This is going to have all the detail in the wheels. So we want to make sure that's captured. Once again, we draw that fence around the outside of the wheels in, you know, good enough detail. We invert it, we select delete, and there you go. We're going to do the same with that bottom plane. Once again, we're going to delete it off. You'll see I do chop a little bit of that upper bit as well. Try and get as much in there as you can and rotate around. You'll just have to practice so that you get the kind of orientation aspect of things nailed down. And it really is simple to do, honestly. If I can do it, anyone can do it. That's my motto here. There you go. We've got our two scans looking good, looking clean. All of the junk is gone. So what we're going to do now is click on the process tab and we are going to align them so that they join up and we've got one pretty complete scan. So I tried to do an auto align first. It didn't work. You're going to see here it's upside down all over the place. So I switched to a manual, and what you do here, holding the shift button again, you look at key features on both scans and you point them out to each other. So you can see I'm rotating the scan so it's orientated the same way, and that's pretty much there. It's quite hard to actually tell, but side on, they are now orientated. So now shift and left mouse button, click approximate areas that you know are the same areas, and it's really intuitive actually. Originally I was trying to get my points exactly on, but you don't need to, it just needs to be in the ballpark. So here you go, I did a wrong point there, so shift and right click to remove the wrong ones. So shift and left click, we've put 1, 2, and 3, click align, and you'll see now, look at this. This is the magic right here. It has put it together and it looks blimmin' great. I love that, absolutely excellent. So there you go, we've now got our two scans joined up. That's the most complicated part for a lot of people, but it was easy as you saw. Now we're gonna go to meshing. This is where it's gonna create a load of little triangles and smooth things out and also remove any isolated parts to give you a nice clean finished fused scan. So let's do that here. I'm gonna speed up. It takes a bit of time to load. You'll see with mine, I've got loads of little yellow pockets. They are the holes. We can fill them, and we are gonna fill them manually in this case because they are quite intricate holes. So the way we do this, click on the manual tab. There are different things you can select. We have gone with curvature in this case, and it's highlighting in green the areas that it can fill. I've obviously sped this up. It takes a little bit of processing power, but I'm literally just picking the holes and filling them with a left mouse button click, and it works really well. And you know, you can see right here though, that scan, there's a lot of detail it has missed because of the depth and the intricate colors and different things. This is the thing with 3D scanning, nothing's ever simple, but it's doing a really good job of just filling holes so that we get a good enough shape. You know, if you fill the holes, it means you can then 3D print it and do stuff like that. So hopefully you've learned something here, because I don't use the manual fill very much, but this was a great bit of practice for me. After we've got our holes filled, we are then going to do the color mapping, which is up in the process tab again. That will literally apply the colors that it's picked up during the scan to the various surfaces. Right, first thing we're going to do though is look at our finished scan. Look at this, it looks brilliant. I'm very, very impressed with the wheels, the top. It picked up the shiny metal very well. I'll be doing one of these videos showing the OtterLite scan, and that one struggled with the kind of exhaust manifolds coming out of it. This one looks great, and I think you'll find it's done a good enough job. We could do much better if we sprayed it. Now we're going to compare the color scan and the photo comparison. There you go, look at that, it looks great. I mean, I love the fact that I've just scanned that and it has come to life. Absolutely brilliant. So thank you so much for watching, guys. I'm going to be doing more of these, so follow the channel, and thank you for your support.